Hey, what's good, guys? It's Clutch City Entertainment here, back with another video. And for today's video, I'm just going to be talking about the Houston Texans. And I'm just going to give a question out. What if Deshaun Watson were to play next season? With all the legal allegations going on, all of that legal stuff, and then on the football side of stuff, him not wanting to play here, him wanting a trade and all of that. But let's just put hypothetically, Deshaun Watson is the week one quarterback next season. He doesn't get suspended, he doesn't get traded, he doesn't sit out, but he plays. He plays all 17 games and he just plays. He gives it his all. He doesn't play like, he doesn't really care, any of that. He just plays at 110% like he's been doing. In my opinion, I believe we will be much better than last season. We all saw last season when we went 4-12. But I believe our record doesn't show, I guess, the type of football team we were last season. A lot of those games were one-score games, or where guys like Kiki QT fumbled the ball, or Nick Martin gave a bad snap, or the defense let off the gas or just blew the game for the offense or for the whole team. We saw that happen multiple times with the games against the Colts, where Kiki QT fumbled the second game, and Nick Martin fumbled the first game, and then with the Titans, where the defense pretty much lost us both games. We saw with games like the Cincinnati Bengals, where we pretty much messed up on the offense in the last minute. We just saw it multiple times. We saw it in the Pittsburgh Steelers game, where we were winning in the first half, and in the second half, we came out and we looked like we just straight up didn't know how to play football. It's happened multiple weeks and multiple games last season, and I believe if we put that all together this coming season, we have a much better running back room. We have Mark Ingram, David Johnson's coming back, we have Phillip Lindsay. The wide receiver room, sure, we lost Will Fuller, but we signed a guy like Chris Conley. We're probably going to draft a guy. Randall Cobb is coming back from injury. It's not a terrible receiver room as everybody thinks and as it looks right now. Sure, we don't have the big name receiver like DeAndre Hopkins or Will Fuller or anybody like that, but we have Brandon Cooks, who could be a very solid wide receiver for us, a very solid wide receiver one and that. Our tight end room, obviously, it's not the best. It's pretty much the same as last year. All we did was cut Darren Fells. But the offensive line room is where it really got better. We signed a bunch of depth. We let go of guys like Nick Martin, who was terrible for us last season. Zach Fulton, who was also terrible for us last season. And we signed a bunch of depth guys. We signed Justin Britt, who's probably going to be our starting center. We traded for Marcus Cannon, who's going to be your starting right guard. And Max Sharping's probably going to be starting back at left guard again. So, I mean, our offensive line's got a lot better, in my opinion, than last year. We got more veteran guys, more leaders, more guys are going to come in that want to play football and just different stuff like that. So, our offense has got way better as a whole from every position, top to bottom. I mean, other than quarterback, obviously, because it's going to be Deshaun Watson. But the defensive room that also got better, we got a bunch of studs. Terrence Mitchell, very good corner. Desmond King, very good corner. Malik Collins, in my opinion, he's a very good D tackle. Shaq Lawson, very good D end. All of these guys, they're not like the home run hitters like Nick Caserio talked about. They're all like second base hits, third base hits, just different things like that. Like, we don't have a guy who's a home run hitter who's going to come in and be that superstar free agent for us. We just got a guys who are gonna come in, who are gonna do the job, who wanna play football, who wanna perform, and who wanna get paid. All of these guys are on 1-year contracts, or at least most of them are. So they're pretty much playing for a contract. Other teams are gonna see their film from this next season. They're gonna say, hey, he played really well for the Houston Texans. And so they're gonna wanna really play well for us. So I believe that's gonna also make our team very competitive. We're going to be more of a hungry team than last year. Last year, you could obviously see players just straight up stop caring at times. And this next season, it's not going to be like that. For one, we're going to be a better football team. It's going to be more competitive. And two, these guys are going to want to play so they can get their second contract either with the Houston Texans or with a different team in free agency next year. So, I mean, this team all around is a lot better. And then for us to be having a lot of one-score games last year, or games where the offense or defense made a simple mistake that costed us the game, I believe we could truly go like maybe 9-8, maybe 8-9, maybe even 10-7, something like that. I don't see us having a losing record with Deshaun Watson starting all 17 games next season. With just everybody that we have, pretty much a whole new offense other than quarterback, pretty much a whole new defense. I mean, other than safety, I guess. We have Lonnie Johnson, Justin Reed back there. But our defensive line, completely different. Linebacker room, completely different, other than Zach Cunningham. Cornerback room, pretty much completely different, other than Bradley Roby. Our team is just different as a whole, top to bottom. Obviously, they're going to have to put the chemistry together. They're going to have to put all of that in. But I see us really being good next year. Sure, we're not going to be that team that can go into the playoffs and maybe make a run at a Super Bowl, make a run at an AFC Championship game. But I could see us making the playoffs maybe as a wild card, maybe winning in the wild card game, making it to the divisional game, something like that. Like, be one of those sneaky teams that pull off an upset in the playoffs. Like, I don't see us being anything good like Super Bowl or Championship game, as I said, but we can truly be a solid playoff game or a solid playoff team where we can make it and be into the wild card, or maybe even miss the playoffs, but not by much. Maybe like one game where we go maybe 8-9, 9-8, something like that. But yeah, if Deshaun Watson were to play next season, I believe it would be a very good football team. We would put all these positions together, all of these free agent signings. I believe we have like over 30 signings. So I mean, that's crazy how much of a different football team we are from last season. And then to add Deshaun Watson into these mix of players that we have, it's gonna be an insane thing. Obviously, I hope Deshaun Watson plays next year. I hope all of this allegations are fake, that he didn't do it. I hope that he withdraws his trade request. But I mean, all those things that I just said, they're very unlikely. It's looking like he's gonna be traded at some point, maybe in the next year, 2 years, or maybe he's gonna be found guilty, or maybe not. Maybe he is to play. But it's just a bunch of waiting, a bunch of hoping, a bunch of just waiting around, seeing what happens. But yeah, it's Clutch City Entertainment. I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to follow us on Instagram, TikTok, and Twitter at Clutch City ENTX. And I hope you guys have a good day. Peace.